Hey there, what is up? This is Flutter Mentor, and today we're going to figure out how to use themes in Flutter in order to make your life easier. The UI is super simple, just three different containers, one text widget, one elevated button, and a floating action button. That's it, let's get this started with. Theming is essentially the art of making things easier for you by changing up the default Flutter colors. Unlike other videos, I even let the app color be the default one so that you can see it change as we change the themes and its properties. And the first thing we need to do is go to main.dart. Over here on the material app, we already have the title defined and the theme is right here. Now this that is currently here is pretty much the exact same as nothing being here. This and this is the same, and this would also be the same right here. This is how it looks like in default without doing anything else. So typing this in is literally pointless. But when you check out your main.dart, it'll look like this. Just type in theme, theme data, and then within theme data, as you can see, there are a lot of properties. In fact, you can come over to the documentation and check out the theme data class. And here you can see the properties more organized. Like this is how it's in the IDE, but if you scroll a little bit further, you'll see them all listed out and with short descriptions as well. For example, the accent color is the foreground color for widgets, like knobs, text, overscroll, edge effect, etc. And you can pretty much just read everything that it says. There are a lot of properties. If you really want to be a theme master, then I advise you to read them all and experiment with them, because that's the only way you'll know what they really do. But let's get back to the IDE. Now I just showed you that this right here would be the default version of the theme data, but if we want, we can make it .dark and that will massively change the display. And let me just check something real quick. Yeah, let me take out the background color of the scaffold so we can get the default colors. So this is what it would look like without the .dark, and now with the .dark, it looks like this. Quite a heavy difference. You can notice the app bar color changed, the floating action button changed, the background color also changed, and this body of text also changed because it used to be black. But now that the background is black, Flutter automatically changes it to white because that's the defined text color in the dark theme. And by the way, you can also use dark theme right here. And as you can see here, this is the theme data to use when a dark mode is requested by the system. So if you've ever wondered how to set up a regular theme and then a dark theme for those who prefer the dark theme, this will be how. You would just have this theme defined for regular. Obviously it wouldn't be dark, and then here you just have a different one. But that's just a detail I wanted you to know. Let's focus on the regular theme property. Let me show you how to customize the theme data. You just need a theme data object, and then you just change the property. For example, let's make the primary color Flutter's original color, and all the colors will change because this right here is the dark theme version of Flutter's default themes, and we're going to revert it back to the light version, so everything's going to change. Something interesting is that they actually changed the text color of the app bar. That would be because Flutter decided that black would look better on this color than white. If I made it pink accent, it would go white. So it's actually really cool how Flutter is intelligent and tries to help you when you change colors. So you can already tell that there's a lot of work behind the scenes. And by the way, just by changing the primary color, if we had a bottom navigation bar or a tab bar, it would also have the same color as the app bar. However, I usually advise people to just use the primary swatch, because the primary color only defines one color and that's it. But the primary swatch takes a material color and automatically generates different shades of that color. The thing is, here you would have to give it an actual material color from Flutter. If I save it, it will go back to the regular blue. So if I have a custom color, I usually just combine both. There's the custom color as a primary color, and then for the primary swatch colors, I just use a material color that is close to it. And here it shouldn't be this blue, but like I said, it's material colors. If I change it to a blue accent color, you will see that you can't, because that's a material accent color. And that's because Flutter already has the shades implemented. And just in case you're wondering what would change, I'm just gonna make it red and you will see these two change right here. But let's revert back to blue. But let's say we define this color right here and we want to manually apply it to our button right here. Now colors are different, change their color, you gotta do it like this. And then here, in the case of the elevated button, you gotta change the primary property. And instead of doing this, for example, we can use theme.context.primaryColor. And I'm going to save it and it's going to change. Now you might be thinking, that's the same thing, I could have just put in the color code. But once you have a whole app with a bunch of buttons, it will be much better to change the color just in one place rather than in all of the buttons. And that's one of the main advantages of using themes. When I talked about the different shades, for example, here you can access primary color dark, and if I save it, it will be a darker blue. You can tell this blue is darker than this one right here. And you can also do light, for example, and it will be, well, lighter. But let's say you want to change the color of the floating action button through your themes. You would do that through the accent color. For example, let's make it some weird blue, like this one, blue-gray. If I save it, it has changed. And if you have a lot of different pages with a floating action button, obviously it'll be easier to change it through the theme data. And throughout all of my tutorial videos, I've always had the background color defined like this, but let me show you how to define it using themes. And again, if you don't know how you change the scaffold background color, for example, you can just look around here and you could literally just do Control F and just background, and then you just look like this. Eventually you would find it. For example, it's right here, scaffold background color. As you can see, there's literally so many different properties that I can't go over all of them. The video would just take forever and you would probably not withstand to watch it. And that's why I try to make videos as short as possible. But yeah, all you have to do is type in scaffold background color, define a color, and then save it. And that's it. The color changed. I don't know if you noticed it. Let me just use a different color just to make sure you got it. There you go. But now we can't see the text. So let's change the text, shall we? Now the text, you gotta do text theme. And then if you use Control Q, you will see that it expects an object of the type text theme. So let's give it that text theme again. And as you can tell, there's a lot of different things to be defined as well. And we can come here and we can just click the text theme, and here everything will be explained to you. They even give you a nice table to simplify it. But if you just keep scrolling, you'll get to this part. For example, body text used for emphasizing text that would otherwise be body text too. And this is the default text style for material. So which one would we change in order to change the text that was once visible right here? Pause the video and think for yourself a little bit. I hope you got it right. If you didn't, that's okay, because you're here to learn. Before the deprecation of these two, it used to be body one, but now it's body text two. And in here, it expects a text style. So let's give it exactly that. And then here, you just gotta give it a color. Let's make it white. And if we save it, it goes to white, as you can see. And this would also work if you try to use something like that dark, but not in the same way. In this case, you would have to use a different method, which is the copy with method. And within here, you could paste this, although it does not have a primary swatch. And let's get rid of the text theme as well, because it will fix it by default. And this isn't necessary either. So if I save it, now it's in dark theme. Although the floating action button actually didn't change. If you wanted to change it, you would have to use this property right here, which takes exactly what you would expect the floating action button theme data. And here you could change, for example, the background color and give it this color right here and save, and then it would change the color. This is why you should play around with the themes to really understand the differences between using dark and light and defining all the properties by yourself, etc. You will only master it if you use it a lot. And you can actually go to a button and give it its own theme. You just wrap it with a theme widget, and then you use the data property, which takes the theme data object, and then you just do theme data and let's make it dot light and see the button's color change. There you go, because we just gave it its own theme, ignoring the whole theme of the app. And earlier I forgot that you can also use this expression right here, theme dot of context, to apply it to any kind of widgets. We can just make all of these widgets have the theme color just with this piece of code, like so. And lastly, we can also define a button theme. In the new update, you can also define specific types of button themes. So you can define a theme for elevated buttons, for text buttons, and for outline buttons, giving you more control over buttons. But in this case, let's just go over the button theme in general. Here, what you would do would be button theme dot of context, so that you don't have to define everything. This way you can use the default and then just change what you want to change about it. Copy with, and in here we can change, for example, the button color. Let's make it something completely different, red. And then the text theme, for example, we can access the primary color, like so. And we can even define a shape for all buttons. For example, let's use this rounded rectangle border, and then let's give it a border radius dot circular 20. And if I save it, nothing will happen, because this kind of theme actually only applies to former buttons. If I just do this really quick and I save it, now you see that the button theme was applied. And really quick, let me just show you an elevated button theme in action. And here you just style it like you would style any other elevated button. I'm just gonna paste this for the shape parts, and then I would change this part to colors.red. And very importantly, I cannot forget to remove this right here so that it actually uses the theme data. And I'm gonna save it, and there it is. I hope you now have a better grasp at how to use themes in Flutter. If this video helped you in any way, please drop a like and subscribe if you want to keep on learning Flutter. That's it for now. If you have any questions, just drop them in the comments below. This is Flutter Mentor, and out.